The U.S. Justice Department will review the law enforcement response to the Texas school shooting. The unusual look back, which was requested by Uvalde's mayor, was prompted by questions about the shifting and at times contradictory information from authorities. The frustration, anger, and questions about the response from police grew deeper on Friday after authorities revealed that despite repeated 911 calls from students and teachers, the school district's police chief had told more than a dozen officers to wait in a school hallway. The announcement of the review came as President Joe Biden was visiting Uvalde, where he and First Lady Jill Biden paid their respects at a memorial to the 19 students and two teachers killed on Tuesday. This comes less than 2 weeks after making a similar trip to the site of another mass shooting in Buffalo, New York.
Ukraine President Volodymyr Zelensky visits the country's war-ridden east for the first time since the Russian invasion. In a video posted by the president's office, Zelensky is shown wearing a bulletproof vest and being shown heavily destroyed buildings in Kharkiv and its surroundings. After the visit, Zelensky announced that he had fired the northeastern city's security chief in a rare public rebuke. He says the official was dismissed for not working to defend the city from the first days of the full-scale war. Meanwhile, Russia claims it has captured the strategic town of Lyman and surrounded the urban center of Severodonetsk as it wages an all-out war for the Donbas region. A Ukrainian official denies Severodonetsk has been encircled, saying government troops has repelled Russian forces from the outskirts of the key city. Torrential rains in northeastern Brazil have now left at least 56 people dead and dozens missing. The number of dead mounted steadily over the weekend, with at least 28 killed in landslides, as heavy rains caused rivers to overflow and torrents of mud swept away everything in their path. Authorities warned that heavy rain was forecast to continue Sunday, but the storm subsided in the morning. Civil defense officials capitalized on the lull to search for survivors. They, however, warn the downpours are expected to continue in the next few days. The disaster is the latest in a recent series of deadly landslides and floods triggered by extreme weather in Brazil.
A passenger plane with 22 people on board goes missing in Nepal. The Twin Otter aircraft took off from the western town of Pokhara at 9:55 a.m. Sunday, but soon lost contact with air traffic control. The Ministry of Home Affairs says two helicopters have been deployed for a search operation, but visibility was low due to bad weather. Nepal's aviation industry has boomed in recent years, flying tourists, trekkers, and climbers, as well as goods to remote corners where road access is limited. But the impoverished Himalayan nation has a poor air safety record due to insufficient training and maintenance. The European Union has banned all Nepali airlines from its airspace over safety concerns. The European Union fails to agree on a Russian oil ban ahead of an emergency summit in Brussels this week. A senior EU diplomat further dampened hopes for a deal, saying that there are still too much details to sort out. The proposed ban on Russian oil imports is part of the EU's sixth sanctions package on Moscow over its invasion of Ukraine. Talks on the embargo have been going on for a month now with no progress. The whole package has been blocked by Hungary, which says the move would deal a blow to its economy since it cannot easily get oil from elsewhere. Slovakia and the Czech Republic have the same concerns.